right, welcome to Bali, a beautiful island in Indonesia. Not only did I have fantastic Indonesian student in my career, I also had the privilege to go and dive on the reef here. This is why I'm bringing you to this beautiful island. So let's start with this facies model. So when you look at the facies model for modern rimmed platform, you see that the reef, of course, is a dominant feature. And we know that the reef has a function, which is to break wave energy. So we can look at the fore reef, what comes before the reef, so towards the basin. And there we have the slope as an environment and the basin as another environment. Now, both of these environments are below the fairweather wave base. In the basin, we expect to have shale and pelagic limestone, and the dominant texture, because we're in such a protected environment below fairweather and even below storm wave base, the dominant texture, dominant texture, are mudstones. The slope is a bit more complicated because we have a lot of resedimented carbonates coming from the reef where the wave action is so strong. And so the type of facies that you can expect are grainstone, rudstone, floatstone, and even some waxstone, but mudstone are less common, although not impossible, of course. Now, beyond the reef and including the reef, this is known as the carbonate-rimmed shelf itself. The reef is the area of maximum energy, so that's maximum wave energy, as we've already discussed. So what you can expect at this location are reefs and carbonate sand bodies, so shoals and things like this. And in terms of fabric, expect bound stones, that's the reef itself, or grain stones, so very coarse fabric that indicate this high energy, as we've discussed when we looked at the Dunham classification. Then behind the reef, we're in a protected environment. And there we have the lagoon and tidal flat carbonates. And the dominant textures would be waxstone, mudstone, etc. There's also an area that is in the tidally influenced zone, but can be exposed at time. This is known as the subaerial area or the supratidal carbonates. And there typically you'd expect mudstone. So very, very fine lithologies that are deposited at high tide. Yes, that's right. My field location for this class is not a field location at all. It's a city. It's the city of Doha in the state of Qatar. Qatar is a state that thrived on pearl fishing in the past, but now sits on one of the largest gas reservoirs in the world, which is a Permian carbonate. And Qatar also sits on the Arabian Gulf or the Persian Gulf, which is one of the best modern examples of carbonate ramps, hence my choice of Qatar. So let's look at the facies model for carbonate ramps. And on this diagram, you can see that on carbonate ramps, we of course do not have a well-developed reef. This does not mean that we don't have reefs. You will see that in the Persian Gulf we have reefs, but just the reefs do not form a barrier. So what's the barrier to energy of waves? Well, it's the shoal. So waves come and crash on the shoal. That shoal is typically sandy. It can be skeletal sand or it can be ooidal sand. It doesn't really matter. It's one or the other. But typically you have shoals that form the barrier to energy. And that what the shoal is what allows us to distinguish between different parts of a carbonate ramp. So we have the outer ramp, which is below the storm wave base. And because it's below the storm wave base, it's dominated by shales, pelagic limestone, and mudstone in terms of Dunham textures. Then we have the mid-ramp, which is still before the shoal. Now, the mid-ramp is below fairweather wave base, but above storm wave base. So what you end up having are thin bedded limestone, which represents storm deposits, and you can also have mud mounds present. The typical distribution of Dunham texture is more complex there. We expect grainstone, rudstone, perhaps floatstone, or even waxstones. And then we have the inner ramp. The inner ramp comprises the shoal itself and everything that is more landward from the shoal. So the shoal is wave dominated, of course, and it forms a beach barrier or a strand plain if you want. So essentially it's a massive body of sand that can contain patch reef but do not form like continuous reefs, because if it formed continuous reef you'd have a rimmed platform. And the main texture you can expect are grain stones. And then beyond into the inner ramp, you're in a protected environment where you can have subaerial deposits. It's a very, very low angle dipping systems. And you typically have lagoons, tidal flat, supertidal sabkha, for instance, evaporites, paleo soil, paleo karst, etc. And the range of fabric Dunham textures you expect are from waxstone to mudstones. And again, really, the shoal is where the wave breaks. And so you always want to know where the shoal is to know whether you are in the inner ramp, the mid ramp, or the outer ramp. So we're back on the ship now, and I hope you enjoyed that tour of carbonate sedimentology. In the next lecture, we're going to start looking at sequence stratigraphy and truly trying to understand the nature of sediment in space and in time.